The first thing, you need to install that Python SDK for the Gemini API. So that Gemini API is that contained in that Google Generative AI package. So that package, you can install the dependency using the pip actually. So on the first thing, I can first install in my Colab notebook. So let me install it. All right. So the next thing, I need to import that some necessary application, sorry, necessary packages in my script actually. So in that, so I can use that pathlib and text wrap for the better formatting experience. And here is the core library for our video, google.generativeAI as GenAI actually. And also along with that, so I can use some additional library for the display and the markdown for that better formatting output actually, to get the better formatting. And the next thing, we are going to first formatting that Google Gemini, that raw text responses, right? So that part I need to mark down that. So I can create a function to mark down. So if it is dot, if it is comes, then it will be give you a space and put a star, like bullet wise actually. And that just I can put the lambda and we can wrap the text and put the intent like that. So I can just add it over there. So, all right. So the next thing, setting our API key actually. So before we start our Gemini API, so we need to must obtain that API key. So if you don't already have one, create a key with one click in that Google AI Studio. So in that, getting the API key from that Google AI Studio, we already posted that one video. So you can just coming back to that actually. So under coming to that video, so in that, the first thing I can type to mention that our API key actually. So Google API key like that. And after that, so I'm already copied that key, so I can just paste it out. All right. So the next thing, I can configure that genai.configure API key is equal to Google API key. So, all right. So this part was done. And the next thing, now we are ready to use that Gemini API. So using the list model, so to see that what are the available Gemini models to respective with our API key actually. So basically Gemini models have two types, Gemini Pro and Gemini Pro version. So Gemini Pro used for the optimized for text only prompts, Gemini Pro version used for the optimized text and images prompts actually. So in that, let me type the code. So here's the code. So in that, I can just first looping that GenAI list model object. And after that, I'll get the generate content supported generation method, which is belong to the Google API key. And after that, I'll just return the name actually. So if I run that, let it see. Yeah, now we have your two models, Gemini Pro and Gemini Pro version actually. So in that, for detailed information, so I can give that. So this is some free to use actually. Any of the developers can use this API. But they are the restrictions, so they're restricting that rate limit increases. So in that, Gemini Pro models is 16 requests per minute, that means the RPM actually. And yeah, and that GenAI, right, the GenAI package also support the POM family, PALM, POM family of the models, but only the Gemini models support that generic multimodal capabilities of the generic content actually. All right, so the next thing, we can generate the text from the text input actually. So like question answer, yeah. So for the text only prompts, you can use that Gemini Pro models actually. So let me type. So here is the thing, model equal to GenAI, generative model. So I can call the Gemini Pro model actually. So now the generate content, let me type. So then you can get an understand. Yeah, so I can just add the time. So this cell, how much time will it take to run actually. So the generate content method can handle that wide variety of use cases, including that multi-tenant chart and a multi-model input actually, depending on what the underlying the model supports actually. So this model available only support the text and images as a input and a text as a output actually. In a simplest case, you can pass prompt string to the generative model dot generate content method actually. So in that, I can just type that what is the meaning of life. So in that, I can just computer. So I can just type it and if I run that, so it will be taking some time. All right, now it's complete. So it that time decorator, so the time thing, so will it return that, okay, that's system time 7.58 milliseconds, total 1.39 milliseconds wall time. 7.69 milliseconds actually. So in that, we already creating that markdown function to display the formatted markdown text using the to markdown function actually. So here is the markdown function. So in that function, I can pass the response to this function actually. So let me type. So we have a response and to markdown response.txt actually. So if I run that, now as you can see that computer stands for common operating blah blah blah, so etc like that. So will it return actually? So it's crazy, right? So within the second, as per the same thing, ChatGPT, what it do, that same thing you can do from the using the APIs actually. But that Google Generative API will it give that pro versions. So that's a positive thing. And yeah, all right. So the next thing, we can getting the result as a stream wise also. So I can give the same code. So in that, I can just add the one more argument, stream equal to true. So if I add that, so this also will take same time and it will be returning that some chunk of thing. So if I give that response.txt, so will it write for the complete output of the model, and after that only will it return actually. But if we using this stream.true, will it return real time as a chunk wise actually. So I can use that chunk in the response, I can read as a chunk, and let me print it. So as you can see that within the second, so we'll get that all the details actually. So it's pretty awesome, right? Yeah. All right, guys. So the next thing, we can go to the generate the text from image and text inputs actually. So Gemini provides a multimodal input, Gemini Pro versions that accept both text and images and inputs actually. That generative model, we can use that same generate content API is designed for handling the multimodal prompts and return the text input actually. Let's include the image. So I can using some curl and so, all right. So this is the image URL link. Along with that, I can use some curl command. So it will be downloading that image. And after that, I can read that particular image using that pillow library. So, all right. So here is the image. I can read it that. So this is my image. And this image, I'm going to pass to the Gemini model. And the Gemini model will it return that what exactly in that image. We already seen that videos, right? That Google officially introduced that videos, right? That launch videos. So in that, that person, some using the hand technique, it will be returning that model will returning that what he doing actually. So that same as we have an image, and that image we can pass to through the Gemini Pro version model actually. So now I have a model, generative model actually. So in that I can run it. All right. So the next thing, I can type that response dot. Yeah, in that. So I can just simply type that model.generate content. Under that, I can just simply pass that pillow image and which we get from the curl. And after that, we have a response, and that response, I can pass it to the to markdown method actually. So if I run that, all right, will it wait for some time? Yeah. All right. So here is the thing. These are the glass and containers with compartments filled with white rice, orange, bell peppers and broccoli and a chicken teriyaki actually. So it's crazy, right? So from the image, it will be get understand and it will return that what in that image exactly there actually. So the next thing, to provide that both text and images in a prompt and pass a list of containing and a list string that images actually. So let me type. So here is my thing, and in that generate content, write a short engaging that blog post that based on that picture. It should be include that description of the meal in the photo and talk about my journey and a meal preparing actually. So along with that image, I can pass it over there. So in that, after that, I can just send the resolve thing actually. So if I run that, after that response, will it get that response.txt? Will it wait for some time? All right, now it's completed. So I can just send the same as response.txt to markdown method. And if I run that, meal preparing is a great way, save time and money, blah, blah, blah. And it, what we expect that short note will it return actually. So it's awesome, right? So this is greater than, this is very great compared with the ChatGPT, because ChatGPT purely provides with the text basis actually, but DALL-E, it's a separate service, and this Gemini will it support for both text and images both as well actually. Yeah. So all right. So the next, we can move to the next part, that creating a chatbot conversation actually. So Gemini enables you have to have freedom conversation across the multiple times that chat session. We have a class is there. So that it managing that states of the conversation. So unlike with the generate content, so you don't have to store the conversation as a history as list actually. Let's initialize the chat. So in that, model equal to Gen AI, generate is model as per the same thing Gemini Pro, and a chat equal to model dot start chat actually. So in that history, basically it should be empty, and I can just return the chat. It will be returning that some chat session object actually. And the next thing I can type it. So I can type that chat. We have a chat object. So in that chat object, I can just send the send message. In one sentence, explain how a computer works to a young child. So I can just type it, and that response should be a response.txt actually. So this send message method returns the same generate content response type as a generate content method. So it also appends your message and the response to the chat history. So it will be auto maintaining that. So let me run. All right. So here's the thing, that computer is like a magic box that can store a lot of information and do many things and what to do. So after that, we can see the chat history also. So if I run that chat.history, so as you can see that, so this is my first thing, that user, and the model will it return this messages actually. So it's pretty crazy, right? And the next thing, you can keep sending the message to continue the conversation using that stream parameter actually. So we are already using the stream parameter. So same as you can use that chat.send message. Okay, how about more detailed explanation to your high schooler, like stream true. If I run that, so let it see. So this is for high schooler. So in that, computer's electronic device that programmed to carry out set of instruction. So blah, blah, blah. All those things will be written actually. And the next thing, you can get that all the chat history. If you have a more than chat history, so you can just using this array of chat history, I can just loop it. And in the to markdown method, I can pass that role and a message part. So it will be returning as a chat format actually. So as you can see that user in a one sentence, how computer works to the younger child, and model will return, and user will return, and model will again respond that actually. So it's a great thing actually. So all right guys, so this is what I want to share with you guys. Hope you guys, you really like that video, and if you really like that video, please subscribe to my channel for more videos like this in the future. Also don't forget to share the video to your friends and your colleagues, whoever needs full. Also, if you have any queries or comments, so please leave them in the comment section below. I'm happy to respond, and we'll see you on the next video. Thank you. Bye.